Welcome back to KG Constrictors, and you are looking at a very, very tired mom. This is... I've got to fix this cage. This is, of course, Farrah, my super salmon, who just delivered her fifth litter. Hi, sweetie. And she still has great body weight. And her cage is all nice and clean. And she is a great mom and will get this season off. I was gonna give her this season off, and the reason why I decided not to give her this past season off was because I really wanted to get some clean super salmon babies using her and Lorenzo. Lorenzo is a probable super. He's never proved out because this is his first litter that he sired. So obviously when you put two salmons together, you're always going to get visual salmons. But based on how clean the babies look, based on the fact that he is extremely clean with very little black on him down in his tail area, I'm about as sure as I can be that these babies are going to be supers. When I offer them for sale, I will have to offer them as possibles or probables. But I can't guarantee it because he has not proven out to be a dominant salmon. I mean, for anybody that doesn't understand what a super salmon is a codom gene, and it also can be dominant. So Farrah, both of her alleles are salmon. So if I breed her to any other snake, all the babies are going to be hypo. And if I breed her to another salmon, 50% of those babies are going to be dominant. They're going to be supers like her. So this year I put her with Lorenzo, who, I've got to get him back in his other tub. He's extremely clean. And, I mean, he's in shed right now, but he is just so orange and so clean. That if he's not a super, I mean, I'd be extremely surprised. So I decided that I would breed her this year to Lorenzo because in the fall of 2011, I've got some really cool plans for her. I'm hoping to pick up either a VPI Carmel Albino or a Boa Woman Carmel Albino and a few other... high-end animals, and the next time she breeds in the fall of 2011, I'm going to put her with something like that. Also looking at some jungles and such. So I didn't really want to do any more hypo-to-hypo breedings with her. I got what I wanted. I got some beautiful, beautiful probable salmons. I can keep a couple of the girls back, and you know, those will be like the little Farrah juniors. Very, very clean genetics behind both Lorenzo and Farrah. All salmon and super salmon in their background, orange tails and such. So that's why I decided to do the breeding this year, because I didn't want to wait two more years to do up that breeding, because I have other plans for her that involve something more interesting and more exotic than hypo to hypo. So now she's going to enjoy the rest of this year and eat like a queen. And then this fall, she will not be put with a male. So she's obviously not gonna do much of anything. If she produces any follicles, she'll just reabsorb them if she's not put with a male. And chances are she won't even produce any follicles at all. So. Congratulations to Farrah. Great snake. I got her from a guy named Richard Wilson, who lives in Phoenix. And I got her in the summer of 2004. And I bred her in the fall of 2005 for the first time when she was just a little over 2 years old, about 2.5 years old. And she produced a nice litter in the summer of 2006, sired by my high orange normal male. So I did that for 2 years in a row and sold the babies off and used the money to, you know, deepen my collection, pick up some cages and such. So She is my foundation female, and she's just been fantastic. She's 7 years old, and, you know, boas can live, you know, 20 plus years if you take good care of them. So I expect her to be around a long time, and I'm going to give her this year off. And I'm really looking forward to showing you these babies. I'm going to do another video now outside in the patio, get a good look at them. I mean, of course, they're going to be shedding in the next, you know, 10 days to 2 weeks, but extremely, extremely clean babies, and I'm really, really happy with what I see. So we'll show you the babies next.